I love America. I love it here. I it's not what it used to be. It's kind of a, it's, you know, we like me and my wife and kids, we live in upstate New York, and it's one of these areas where we just, we live, we're in a suburb of Walmart, basically, you know. It's just Walmart and Walgreens and Rent-A-Center. Do you know what Rent-A-Center is? Do you know what goes on in a Rent-A-Center? People go to Rent-A-Center to rent like a chair. Or a couch. How shitty is your shitty, shitty, very shitty life that you need to rent a lamp for $40 a month? And then you go broke and you gotta go, honey, they're gonna take the lamp today. Because we didn't pay the lamp rent. So I go to Walgreens. I just kept going. And Walgreens is depressing because it's a drugstore, but they sell whatever. I go in there, they're selling sweatpants. Right when you walk in, a big rack of sweatpants. It's a drugstore, but they're like, somebody brought them sweatpants, they said, fuck it, they'll buy them, just put them out, it's fine. Right next to the sweatpants, vodka. Big plastic squirt top jugs of shit vodka. How depressing is that? Sweatpants and vodka. That's a whole identity right there. You could buy those two things and just go be that guy in the parking lot of the Walgreens. You know that dude in the sweatpants and no shirt just laying there? His belly's the color of the pavement. He's like a chameleon. He's been sleeping there so long. You know those bums that smell amazing? Like you kind of can't help fantasizing about really smelling them on purpose. I don't know if you do that, but when you smell a bum and you're like, what if I just really dug in there on purpose and wow! Like, did it change me or... And I go to Walgreens and they're selling, you know, I'm going to the back of the pharmacy too, and the pharmacy is the most depressing place in the world. People in Walgreens are just milling around in flip-flops and hitting their kids in the toy aisle, like beating their kids in front of toys. And then they go and buy medication and they don't have insurance. They think they have insurance and they way don't. And every moment, it's like a hidden camera joke. On all these people, it happens, it breaks my heart. They come up, they have a prescription. They're really happy because there's a solution to their problem in their hands. The doctor said, take that, you'll be fine. So they give it to the pharmacist and he goes, yeah, it's gonna be $40,000 for that. And the guy's like, what? But I have insurance. Now we called, they said, fuck you. No. And then the guy always gives him like chewed up gum with hair in it and says, take this, this is what you get. This is your... And they always ask, is this as good as the other one? Fucking no, of course not. The other shit would have cured you completely. And we got shitloads of it too. But none for you, you poor faggot. Go home and die.